Hey guys, welcome back to Stuff and Things for your daily dose of nerd news. On today's episode, we're going to take a look at some new information come up in regards to some remains from Siberia. And they are very old and they give us some very interesting info in regards to the actual ancestry of everyone in North America, at least the original inhabitants. Some remains were dug up over a 20-year span, ending in 58 over in Siberia, in the Malta region over Lake Baikal, or something like that. Really not sure how to pronounce that lake name. A team out of the University of Copenhagen, led by Eska Vilverslev, finally gotten around to analyzing the remains. They've been just sitting around in a museum in St. Petersburg. The person was between the age of 3 and 4, a young male. He lived about 24,000 years ago, during a very, very cold time. This was at the point of a glacial maximum. Pretty much the worst point you could live during the Ice Ages. It was very harsh. But there's people around these areas, they actually lived in sort of hobbit hole-ish areas with dugout houses that were half in the ground, and they had walls of bone and antler. And apparently well known for the religious artifacts and such they could find there. Apparently very accomplished artists for their time. So of course they tested the DNA of the boy and they found that his ancestry was very, very split. There was traces of Western Europe DNA as well as stuff from Asia, like East Asia. So apparently the Siberians were very diverse peoples. A lot of migrations, a lot more than the actual scientists previously assumed. Most interestingly is that this boy's DNA actually shared with 14 to 34% of all Native Americans. But that could not be said for other Eastern Asian genes. So specifically the Siberian group that seemed to compose a lot of the eventual migrants that became what we now know as Native Americans. All this testing was done using the mitochondrial DNA, which only actually passes through the female lines. So what we could have seen is some rampaging Siberian men taking their Asian wives and then going off and doing their thing, I guess. This, of course, is just another little piece of data that we're building to actually understand how the whole migrations work from going from Siberia over to North America. It's still not clearly understood when everything happened. The actual time frames on everything are just so scatterbrained. And really, we won't have much of a clearer picture until we do get some better DNA samples like we got with this boy. And of course, this does raise some interesting questions in regards to the actual migratory patterns of humans. Like, for instance, the East Asians seem to be completely left out of this. For whatever reason, people living in China, all that, didn't migrate at the same time or at all for some reason. Maybe the their Siberian cousins were keeping them out? Maybe that? Hey, maybe they're doing a stalling tactic, or maybe they pushed them out? Maybe they didn't like the Siberian guys? I'd actually love to know your guys' opinions on what you think caused the humans to even migrate in the first place. Was the Ice Age itself the main reason, where the diminishing supplies, diminishing resources available to humans at that point, pushed out from other more capable tribes that had access to stuff in the south, where there was of course more abundance? Let me know in the comments down below what you guys think, and of course if you like what you've seen, do not forget to hit the like and subscribe buttons, whatever it happened to be, and we'll check in the next video.